Hey everyone, it's Invicta, and it's time to do a new solo queue here on the channel. Thank you everybody who's been liking and watching all the ranked stuff I've been doing in League of Legends. Today I'm going to be playing as Pantheon, because as you guessed it, Vi was last to be banned, and that's the reason why I make sure I have backups. I almost considered playing Xin Zhao, but honestly I'm still not quite ready to bring him into second. I'm not ready to make Xin Zhao into the... to put him in the second string. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, a couple of videos ago I talked about how Vi had become my new main jungler, and then after that, of course, Pantheon is number two, and Jarvan was by then number three. He got relegated to the third spot because I really just don't play Jarvan anymore, and ever since then I've kind of explained how I feel like Jarvan is he is the lesser. I have no confidence in my Jarvan ability anymore. I feel like that he is, I don't know, my problem with Jarvan is that I really do feel he's kind of limited as far as the damage that he does, and I also have probably never played him right to the point where I was focusing on damage, because I've always looked at Jarvan as kind of like an initiator and a team fighter, that sort of thing, crowd controlling with Cataclysm and Golden Aegis and whatnot, but that doesn't really suit me. I found out that I like playing the aggressive, as you saw in the previous Vi video, and on some Pantheon videos as well that I've uploaded directly from the stream. I prefer to play a little bit more aggressive. I think that I have the right mindset to be a damage dealing jungler more so than a finesse jungler, I will say that. So Pantheon is up there. Xin Zhao is certainly up there as far as damage is concerned. Obviously Vi is number one for me, but I'm trying to get a little bit better with Xin Zhao, but I still think that Pantheon, I still feel that my Pantheon game is still better than my Xin Zhao game right now anyway. But I am very, very happy that I did indeed pick up Xin Zhao, because he does play very, very fun. He's a very, very fun champion to jungle with, and he matches my playstyle very well. He's basically like this is the way that I look at Xin Zhao. I look at him kind of like he's a poor man's Vi, in the sense that he doesn't have the mobility that she does because he cannot go through the tree lines and whatnot. But he, at least not easily anyway, but he's got the damage to where he can rival Vi, especially if he really starts getting going. He can be quite dangerous. And he just matches my mentality of being aggressive, being mobile, that sort of thing. And Pantheon's not the most mobile champion, I would say, as I do see Nocturne now coming in towards my blue buff, my red buff, I'm sorry, so I do have to be very cautious of that. We'll see if I can catch him. We'll see if I can catch him trying to sneak my red buff here. That'd be very good indeed if I am able to. Let me see if he is here. And he is indeed here, right as I was expecting. Now, I do get terrified. I think that he's actually got the... I'm pretty sure he's got the aggro on the Lizard. Yeah, he's just going to die here. No, there's absolutely nowhere for him to go. And I am able to get First Blood on Nocturne, of all people, and that helps us greatly. Because not only was I able to take his blue buff, but I was also able to make sure that my red buff is secure. And I do have to be somewhat cautious about how much damage I take here from the Lizard, but I think I will be okay. One more hit, and down goes the Lizard. See you later. So a level 2 gank on Nocturne, trying to get cute with it. And again, I saw it coming from a mile away. And what I like about Pantheon is that the execute ability that he has, which is the increased critical damage on targets with low health. That's what I love about him. So here we go. See if we can get Cho'Gath here. Gonna have to be cautious of where he goes. I am gonna stun him for Olaf. I miss Heartseeker, actually gets silenced, but forced to flash away. And actually, it looks like I wasn't expecting Olaf to go after that, but I'm gonna have to go back here. And I was not expecting I was not expecting Olaf to sit there and fight that. I thought for sure that he was gonna pull back, but apparently not. So I am going to grab the boots early here, just because that allows me to get around a little bit faster, and it keeps Pantheon mobile. Pantheon does have one of the highest, I believe he has one of the highest base speeds for junglers. So keeping me being able to dart in and out of jungle camps, also making sure that I'm mobile, moving around the map, that sort of thing, if I ever go to counter jungling, and that's something that I've been trying to work on a little bit better. Which is the counter jungle aspect of the game, which I haven't really been doing all that much. As I'm going to, it does look like Malzahar. Malzahar's not going to have that many issues with Fizz right now, anyway. Fizz is going back. Lucian gets a kill on Alistair. Very nice. Caitlyn almost died. So if I actually headed down there, I probably could have dove that turret to get Caitlyn, but I really don't want to. My farm is already kind of slowed down enough as it is because I not only did I have to contend with Nocturne in the jungle, but then I also went on for a failed gank on Cho'gath, so that put me a little bit behind. I'm in no means saying that Nocturne's doing any better than I am right now, because I am currently dominating him. So unfortunately, Alistar gets a return kill or revenge kill on Lucian. I'm not quite sure how that happened. Apparently Lucian was AFK there, so there's that. And now Cho'gath is... he does have his lane pushed up a fair bit. And let's see if me and Olaf can get take number two on this. And we do see Cho'gath. Actually, Cho'gath just warded that, so I am able to bully him out of this lane. I'm not going to press the matter over because I don't know where Nocturne is. And Nocturne's still only level 3. Or at least he's level 3. No, I think that actually, yeah, he's just still level 3. He hasn't been seen since. So there's my ghoul pack. I was waiting for that to come back up. So 2-1 right now in this ranked game, and as always with these ranked solo queues, this would be more focused on playing properly rather than just the commentary level of that excitement, that sort of thing. Now Fizz does have his ult. I currently do not have my ult yet, obviously, because I'm just now level 5. But the trickster mechanic of Fizz is really the one that makes him very difficult to gank. He is not a fun champion to gank in mid. But it's pretty much what's going to come down to. For me to be able to get a successful gank on Fizz, other than him just falling asleep at the keyboard, will be Malzahar hitting his lockdown ability. I forget the name of his ult. That's going to be much needed here. So I am able to get back on track with a blue buff. Usually if I get standard help, it comes right around the 7 minute 15 second mark around there. And that is something that I've been trying to improve on, knowing my timings, knowing what the timer of the dragon is, that sort of thing. Knowing when a lane is too pushed to not be able to gank, as you see Nocturne up here. And I'm going to grab my red. And I'm kind of leaving bottom alone because I do have everything pretty much well handled. I'm outside of Lucian not paying attention, apparently, at that one time he died. Luckily, it was Alistair who got the kill and not Caitlyn, so that helps. Middle is missing. Not sure where Fizz is. So we'll see if Nocturne is going to make a play for my red buff again. And if he doesn't, then that will be fine with me. My red buff is going to be delayed by about 5 seconds because of the fact that I was killing Nocturne at this time 5 minutes ago. And it took me about 10 seconds to kill him. So as soon as my red buff comes up, I'll consider Grand Skyfalling on Cho'gath. Now I have to be a little cautious about where Nocturne is because he knows roughly what the timers are on my buffs because he was here when I killed him, and he saw that my buff was still up at the time. But, I mean, we are talking about bronze, so whether or not we're playing against somebody who actually pays attention to that sort of thing is beyond me. I don't know the skill level of the people that we're playing against. Olaf going super-duper deep, and it ends up being a trade kill. It does look like Nocturne went bottom, and he was able to kill Lucian, it looks like. I'm going to start pushing this lane forward since Cho'gath is indeed down right now. I'm just going to tax the lane. I needed bottom right now, but honestly, by the time I got there, I'd lose pretty much my blue buff. My blue buff would be gone immediately. And I'd prefer to push this lane right now instead of just tax it due to the fact that I know that Cho'gath is just now rezzing, and we can get some major ground on the top lane. Olaf has had a pretty nice... he's been doing a very nice job at keeping this lane pretty much intact, though. So I am going to start to get a little bit of turret damage here, and then I'm going to back off. And here comes... comes Cho'Gath.
They will know war.
Not sure where Fizz is. Malzahar went back. There's Fizz. So I'm going to dot the I with the ward and then see if I can catch Fizz trying to ward the left bush over here. Malzahar is on the way. Fizz does not know that I'm here, and here he comes. I am going to leap on Fizz. Unfortunately, he's in the tree line right now, but he does use Trickster. And trying to fight this one-on-one, I'm not sure if that's going to work out for you, Fizz. Although Malzahar is not helping for some reason. Fizz flashes. I don't know what Malzahar was doing. I did that to engage Malzahar, not just lose one-on-one. So I'm not quite sure where Malzahar was in that situation, but he wasn't where I needed him to be, that's for sure. So unfortunately, I end up falling.
With pride.
And I wasn't planning on dying, period, there, let alone having to use my flash, but I was also counting on Malzahar to jump in. And he said he was on his way, but then he hung around up here and then took the scenic route. I'm not quite sure what he was doing. But that definitely cost me the kill there.
My spear.
So bottom being pushed heavily right now by Nocturne and everybody. Nocturne is going to get killed by Lucian. And I don't know if I'm going to have a play on these two down here. Now, with Nami going back, it's only me and Lucian. Lucian was semi-hurt. So dip into Tribush, see if they know that I'm here. It doesn't look like they do. And Alistar actually knocks me up while I was going for the leap here. I'm going to make sure I protect Lucian, so I don't want him dying. Again, I'm just going to kind of sit in lane, soak up a little bit XP. Lucian's taking a ton of damage from these creep, though. Needs to be very cautious about that. Nami is back up in lane, and I'm going to resume my jungling duties. Now, luckily, my red buff will be, or my blue buff will be up again in about 15 seconds or so.
With pride.
Which is when I need it. But the last Gankaroo did not go so well. The only thing I really got out of the last buff that I did was really just pushing Olaf's line and then dying to Fizz in the middle. There's my blue buffs back up again. So it should take me a grand total of 10 seconds to kill this buff. And I do see Nocturne hitting up top. Nice call by Malzahar there. So my blue buff went down at 12:54, meaning that it would be back up at 17:54. And Olaf just kills Nocturne outright. So Olaf, man, getting super duper scary now. Here comes Fizz going after Malzahar. I'm going to see if I can grant Skyfall in. I don't think I need to. And yeah, I definitely didn't need to do that. Hit the cancel button a little bit too late on that. Malzahar is able to get the solo kill anyway, however.
Do not provoke me.
So waiting for my red buff to get back here, but Olaf has basically been carrying right now in top lane. He's been dominating Cho'Gath. Cho'Gath has outfarmed him. Take that back. But Olaf has been doing a much better job roaming around than I have. Again, I'm waiting for my red buff, and then I'll go make a play for Cho'Gath. I'd much rather try to gank Cho'Gath than try to gank Fizz. That's for sure. So my buff should be up and about right now. There we go. Right at the 14-minute mark, which is where I was expecting. Yes, I probably could have gone after the... I probably could have gone for the golems there, but I'd much rather... At this point in the game, I'd much rather protect to make sure that no one tries to make a play. Yes, I know that Nocturne's dead, but I need to be... I'm playing a little bit overly cautious because I'm way behind right now since I died. And here comes Nocturne. Nocturne back up. I'm actually going to see if I can help Olaf here. And Nocturne may be running into a trap. And let me see if I can save Olaf. I do get the stun on Nocturne. I don't think he... Oh, it's going to be close. It's going to be so close. Can I get the spear? Run, Pantheon. Run, Pantheon. Get it. Yes. I do get the kill on Nocturne. I'm not going to be able to get the kill on Cho'Gath, but we are able to take out Nocturne again. And Fizz somehow killed Nami. Halzar did call him missing, but I think that me and Olaf should be able to get this turret pretty easily. I think this might kill. There you go. So Olaf is able to get the turret kill. Got to be careful where Fizz is, however. And let's see if they have. There you go. We are able to get a outer turret middle as well. They will know. And look at this. He does have. He does have a blue buff here. Malzahar is saying he's on the way. Here comes Fizz as well. Got to be careful.
Consider it
done. Yeah. I'm just gonna take it. Telling Malzahar that I didn't. I wanted to give Malzahar that, but at the same time, I also didn't want to. I didn't want to risk Fizz taking it because that makes us way weaker. And yeah, Fizz is just so dead right there. Fizz is super duper dead. Now the problem is that took out most of my health, and it's possible that I may get ganked here by Nocturne. Let me see if I can hold out. And Nocturne does so much damage. I am getting terrified by him. I'm still up and fighting, however. I took Nocturne down very, very low. I think Malzahar should be able to get the easy cleanup kill. There you go. On that, someone teleporting in over here. I think it's going to be Cho'gath. And it was Cho'gath. So, bottom really needs to pay attention. I don't feel like they're really. Lucian did get a kill on Alistar there, but a really wild game thus far. Super duper wild game. You finish my Merc Treads. And I'm just going to go straight for good old Brutalizer. I love the Brutalizer. Normally I would buy a Vision Ward here, but we've had pretty good vision coverage this entire game. So, luckily I did not use my ult, and again I was able to. I've been keeping Nocturne shut down fairly well in this game, and we need to take a dragon. Something needs to happen. Olaf going really deep on the inner turret up top. And I'm letting everyone know that I'm going to make a play for the dragon here. Fizz is down. I think that they're going to go for the turret.
Onward.
I cannot kill the dragon solo right now. If I try, it's probably going to end up killing me. Hopefully, Malzahar will come help me. It looks like he is. I always double check to make sure what smite damage I have. There you go. So,
let us press on.
Called the wrong time. Malzahar. Fizz is trying to run back. I think I may be able to get an easy kill here on Fizz. Yeah, see you later, Fizz. Oh, no! He was able to trickster out of that. I thought for sure, at least, if I was not going to get it, then Lucian would have, but apparently not. And here comes Alistar. Alistar runs headfirst into me and Lucian. And, oh yeah, you're so done, Alistar. Very nice job there. I can't believe Fizz was able to get away.
They will know war.
I'd rather, we're not going to be able to take that inner turret, and I'd rather keep my timers somewhat consistent. Make sure I don't take it from Malzahar this time. And somehow I end up getting the blue buff anyway. Not sure what Nami's doing so far away, but Fizz is not safe here. And see you later, Fizz. Chomp down here. I keep trying to give Malzahar my blue buff, and I keep accidentally taking it. I swear it's not my intention.
Immediately.
So Lucian on a killing spree, dominating Caitlyn right now. We know that Nocturne is somewhere down below. going to dot the I. I think he was going after Lucian, it looks like. I do not have the man drop in yet, but I don't think I'm going to need to be quite honest. Double kill for Lucian. Nice job there by Lucian. Yeah, I didn't even need the man drop. So we are running wild in the enemy's jungle right now. No, I'm not going to go for the turret. Although here comes Fizz. Where did Fizz come from? And can I get away? Can I get away? I think I'm bare. No! Did he have Ignite on me? He must. Yeah, he ignited me. Okay. I should have been able to get away from Fizz there had he not ignited me. But the enemy team's going to surrender anyway, a 20-minute surrender. So kind of a sloppy win, I dare say, for me. I didn't play the greatest of games. I had a couple of solid early game ganks, but after that I was just kind of clowning around trying to give Malzahar my blue buff there. So as always with the rank queues, we're going to take a look at the final stats, and apparently I've qualified for the next series, so there's that. Final total of 5-3-2. I end up finishing dead last on the champion value. And I was also dead last in CS, but I was roaming quite a bit. I mean, I did have the second most kills. Lucian ended up just dominating anyway. So thank you for watching, everyone. Going to wrap it up here. And, of course, I do appreciate everyone watching and enjoying the ranked solo queues. I know that I still have fun playing the game, even though that it can get annoying sometimes when you're losing on a losing streak, that sort of thing. In the end, the game is still a phenomenal game. I love playing it, so... Yeah, I didn't play a great game. Not going to consider that a good game. But, hey, a win's a win. So, thank you for watching. Hope you had a fantastic day. Of course, I'll see you all next time. So long, everybody.